Try it. I love it. I love it. So, y'all, many of you are from Virginia, and many of you are probably from other places too. I'm from Indiana, which is a place that's not Virginia. You're from Indiana too? Sorry. That's actually close to Chicago, so it's fine. You're welcome. Good for you. I forgot what the fuck I was going to talk about. But my name is Austin Lucas, and I'm from Indiana. And I'm feeling great to be here. Actually, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm feeling a level above. And if any of y'all are coon-ass motherfuckers from the country like I am, then you're going to know what this means. I'm feeling a little bit scared. That is the most elevated fucking way of being that an American person can be. And I feel that way. I put this fucker down for a second and it went out. I don't have a tuner. I have a tuner for my electric guitar. And, it's fucking whatever. That's cool. I'm going to play some of my songs. I'm also going to play some Against Me songs. I put out a record last week called Reinventing Against Me. I love Against Me, and I'm a country singer, but I'm a punk. I just wanted to prove what fucking great songs those songs are, no matter what kind of presentation they get. Anyway, this song is a folk version, but not a folk punk version of an Against Me song, and I hope you will enjoy it. Dear mother, this is just survival. Can't promise your children anything. Though you would die if they could sleep tonight. Defeat takes nothing like you said. A legacy of making me a man. For justice I can't change. And a voice I can't forget. Fight every fight like you can win. An iron fist and champion. An iron will soak up. Speak to me. Why Jesus never called on me to part the fucking sea. Why dying's easier than living. He wants anything when you're on your fucking knees, but not today. Not my son, not my family. Not while walking you're still honest and you haven't given up on me. Shithead, this isn't happening. The sky ain't really falling. The face is made of lead. There's asbestos in the walls. Welcome to rip off the doors of the privileged in their mansions. Oh boy, I love to see it. It's a dream, but we can taste it. If we reach out, we can take it. They aren't untouchable, no. Untouchable, but they need us to believe. Oh, but can anybody tell me why God won't speak to me? Why Jesus never called on me to part the fucking seas? Why dying is easier than living? You can host anything when you're on your fucking knees, but not today. Not my son, not my family. Not while walking you're still honest, and you haven't given up on me. Guitar does not like to be in tune. This guitar is a borrowed guitar, so I just want to thank this guitar and the person who borrowed this guitar. Owned it to me. They are very, very kind. Their name is Scotty, and they're going to be playing guitar here. They let me borrow two guitars.
so that I can make rock and roll for you. And so I'm very, very eternally grateful. This guitar doesn't like the same tune, but you know what? It's walking to its own fucking, its own drummer. Just like all of us, right? Well, I'm going to play one of my own songs. I'm going to play a few of my own songs. Has anybody actually ever heard my music before? All right, well, this song is an old song of mine. This song I like to talk about because I believe that this song is about the people who are doing the true fucking Lord's work out there in the world. And that is when they go home for the holidays or when they're hanging out with their friends and relatives who are ignorant-ass fucking racist, transphobic, fucking homophobic, fucking anti-Semitic pieces of human fucking patriarchal filth. That when they say fucking garbage, those people make it weird around the Christmas dinner table. That's right, I don't give a fuck how good fucking Uncle Dale's fucking gravy is. That fucking asshole can get fucked. And if you keep your mouth shut, because it's hard, I understand. If you're a person who is marginalized and you feel like you need to stay silent because you've been silenced your whole life, I understand that. But for those of us who do have the privilege to look motherfucker dead in the face and be like, your ideas are fucking bullshit. There's somebody in here and they're like, I don't have a racist Uncle Dale. You're the racist Uncle Dale. Anyway, this song's called Somebody Loves You. I don't, but somebody. Show for life is just you lay roses on the ground and turn lies the common wisdom. You're every man when it suits you. Yes, I know. Whatever good you've done is for fines made of wrong, and your Savior may forgive you. But I won't. Oh, but somebody loves you. I guess they don't know better. There's a fool for every fool. And somebody loves you. Somebody loves you. And how can it be true? There's a fool for every fool. And somebody loves you. It was from you I learned some men cannot be trusted. And from you I learned some friends do not inspire. Cause you loved my brother, but you filled my heart with anger. And I'll thank you when those lessons have helped it all. Your stories gave me life and they flow through me like wine. They were darkest pitch like arrows to my soul. I was your true believer, now my bones do shake and shiver with a poison that does rot me to your core. Although I did once love you, I guess I knew no better. I was once that fool, and I didn't love you. I did once love you, how can it be true that I was once that fool, and how I love you. I'm a professional. Now, like some ghastly phantom voice, a lifelong companion, or a devil on left shoulder lashing tongue, I spit cross and spike the language like some drunkard to the heavens. When to hell he knows his spirit is surely bound. I'll be rolling all around, and the but whatever good I've done is dwarfed by mountains made of rock. And that truth comes cold and black out the sun. Oh, but somebody loves me, I guess they don't know better. There's a fool for every fool, and somebody loves me. Somebody loves me, yeah. How can it be true that I was once that fool, and how I love you? Thank you so much. So how's it going so far? Everybody's here to see Ann Beretta, so you wouldn't expect a lot from an opener, not a lot of stage show bravado and quality, but hold on a second, I'm about to fucking Lady Gaga this motherfucker. Yeah. Just kidding. That wasn't even actually good enough.
It was amazing.
It was. It was absolutely fucking incredible. Somehow, some way.
Capitalism is rotten to the fucking core, and all it wants to do is fucking sell us back, sell our subcultures back to us. No matter what it is the most insidious fucking thing in the whole world, and it wants nothing to do with anything that is alternative or fucking different until they figure out how to commodify it to us and sell it back to us. This song is called Unbroken Hearts because it's so fucking hard to keep on fucking doing it without your fucking head raised. That's all it is, alright? Anyway, this goes out to anybody who's fucking keeping them shit solid. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah! Alright, let's do it! We'll be right back.
is about a polycule. This song, it's a polyamorous relationship between three people who love each other very much, but sort of destroy each other's lives. Anyway, this goes out to all my college people out there. Do your level best to keep it honest.
There's at least one of you out there, even who the fuck you are.
Oh,
Please tell me why we couldn't stay.
more than ever because as I've gotten older, I have not gotten, I have not swung to the right. I have gotten much, much further to the left. And maybe it's a sign of the times and how fucking just absolutely fucked up the world is right now, but it just is not the time to just let yourself grow old in suburbia and make kids and shit. Don't get me wrong to all y'all who are doing that, doing it right, raising them right. Please and thank you. Keep on doing it, alright? But keep in mind that they need to know things, okay? The religious right is out there trying to indoctrinate them, trying to steal their fucking books away, trying to steal their fucking medical fucking healthcare away. And it is not fucking cool. And this is not the time to be a fucking center, fucking left, liberal person. Now is the time to be a fucking angry ass motherfucking left. This song goes out to my ex-girlfriend. And look, she was absolutely wonderful in many, many ways, but it did not work out. Because at the end of the day, it's really, really hard to go back to premise on these things with somebody all the goddamn time. And to explain the importance of it when it's in your core to somebody who you love all the time, day in, day out, just doesn't work. Through the best of times, through the worst of times, through the waking and the sleeping strong. Someone rocked too hard and turned off my power strip. I know. Somebody was just like, I don't like this musical shit. I'm gonna turn off the power. I'm just the one guitar. I still want to hear the rock. I just want to punish that one fucking person who's talking shit on the microphone. I'm a racist Uncle Dale, and I do not like it. No, sir, no.
Thank you.
You gotta watch out for my power strip.
Alright, sorry.
Alright, so, thank you. That was really fun, wasn't it? We got I feel it's stupid. It's like, I know that it was fun. I'm ready to ask your approval. We had a time together. So, I just want to say, first off, I have to apologize because the reason that Ann Beretta is playing her last show is my fault. The reason they're playing it tonight is my fault. So, the reason that we're all here today is because I wrote to Rob and I was like, hey, do you think if the next time I come through Richmond, that Ann Beretta would want to play a show with me? And Rob's like, yeah, that would be fucking awesome. Let me check that with everybody. And I was like, cool. And Rob wrote back and was like, yeah, so the good news is we're fucking in. We're going to play with you. And I was like, that's the shit. He's like, the bad news is it's our last, going to be our last show ever. And I was like, hold on a second. I called up my bud. He'd be like, hey, could you come book me a show? Hi, we're all punks. What's up? Can we do something? And I get to actually take part in this monumental thing, which is the last Ann Beretta show that happens tonight, which is sad as shit. But, like, holy fuck, I can't believe that I get to play it. I would not have imagined that they would have chosen me as their opener. I would imagine that they would have been like, you know what, kid? You're cool. We'll see you on down the road some other time. But they didn't. And that...
Way to break Richmond Park, you piece of shit.
My fault. And the way that I'm going to make it better is to play a song that's about the worst Chinese buffet in Memphis, Tennessee. And this is one of my songs, and this literally is about a bomb shelter-looking Chinese buffet in Memphis that I went to when I was in the middle of about to get divorced, and I was having a really bad day. Is anybody here divorced? If you want a little bit of a life hack, the next time that you tell somebody you're divorced, just tell them you're a divorcee and stick your pinky out and just give them a sip. Because then people are like, ooh, that sounds French. I would fuck them. Anyway, this song goes out to all my divorced queers out there who tried to drown their sorrows in Chinese buffet. And discovered only just got an upset stomach and a broken heart.
We'll be right back.
I don't wanna know people like that anymore.
Fucking knock you the fuck out.